Los Alamos, AFTV 7, video recording, dated 22 September 1989.
Presentation of the changes, improvements, and discrepancies noted during the Charlie and Delta pontoon changeout.
Here we have the log room located in Delta pontoon, upper level. We've had some changes from the old log room. For one, the engineer's office has been expanded. The bulkhead has been moved out further, which is made for a larger engineering office. The log room itself has been reduced in size, as the bulkhead that you see here has been moved in to allow more room for the IC shop, which is on the other side of the bulkhead. Electrical shop, Delta Pontoon. A view of M Division office space, labeled boat shop on the door. This is the Delta port side wing wall stairwell. We're at the point which the pontoon bolts to the wing wall. We proceed down into the rabbit run on the port side Delta pontoon. Much of the overhead cables that originally ran through the rabbit run has been now routed through the false overhead of the rabbit run. We're now in the switchboard room, Delta pontoon. This was previously a boiler room. The change that we'd like to point out is the ballast control panel for Delta pontoon that was previously in the number two switchboard room, which is now number two generator room, has been installed from what used to be the old boiler room, which is now currently the switchboard room. We have a view of the central passageway, Delta pontoon. There's a port ladder in the vestibule, Delta pontoon. As you can see, the relationship of the scuttle to the ladder. We have a topside view of the hatch. As you can see, the scuttle's located in the center. We're now located at the aft end of the dry dock, looking at the after outrigger. One improvement has been the addition of bumper guards on the after outrigger. Now located Delta pontoon outboard starboard side, looking at the starboard wing wall, Delta section. We're now located on Charlie pontoon outboard port side. We're looking at Charlie wing wall port side outboard. Also, we have here the exhaust box, which houses the exhaust line for the ship service diesel engine, and with the installed mufflers. We're now located in Charlie pontoon. This is Charlie pontoon's central passageway. Here you can see escape trunk leading down to Charlie engineering spaces. Leads down into the switchboard room. This is port side vestibule. In the switchboard room, Charlie pontoon. This used to be the boiler room. And as you can see, there is a difference between Charlie and Delta. Here we have CO2 system installed in the switchboard room. In Delta, the CO2 system was installed back behind the number two ship service diesel generator. As we look into the number two engine room, we have the AFFF station mounted inside the engine room. In Delta, this AFFF station is mounted here in the switchboard room. The likelihood of a Class Bravo fire is naturally greatest in one of the two engine rooms. We have Charlie, ship service diesel generator. Same basic installation as what we saw in Charlie in Delta. This is number two, Charlie number two, and as you saw in Delta number two, we had a different configuration of saltwater piping. This gauge board is readily accessible, plenty of room to get by. Much better insulation as compared to Delta. Here we have a view of the generator, number one generator. And here we have the fuel day tank. Located in number two generator room, Charlie Pontoon, starboard side of center line. And here we have the lube oil storage tank. We're now in the number one pump room, Charlie Pontoon. We're looking at the dewatering pump. And here we have the 371 emergency diesel for the ASW pump, with the ASW pump motor behind that, and the duplex strainers on the discharge side of the pump. To number two pump room, we see the number two dewatering pump, number one and number two sanitary pumps. On the other side of the dewatering pump, we have the bilge pump. And we also have a large eductor mounted on the discharge side of the dewatering pump, number two. Looking into number one engine room, we see the gauge board for the ship service diesel generators. Easy access to the gauge board on number one engine. To the aft end of the number one engine room in Charlie, we see the medium pressure air system for the starting of the ship service diesel generators. We have three flasks. We have a reserve flask, and number one and number two flask. Over here on the port side of the number one engine room, we see the sludge transfer pump and associated piping. Towards the number two engine room, over to the forward side of the diesel generator, we see the fuel oil purifier. It's been installed. Move into the number two engine room in Charlie. Again, you can see the gauge board is easily accessible as compared to what we previously showed in Delta. Looking now on the forward side of the ship service diesel in number two engine room, Charlie Pontoon, we see the medium compressor, medium air compressor for starting air for ship service diesels, mounted in the forward center corner of the number two engine room, with the sound booth again mounted in the engine room. We see the electrocatalytic protection has been mounted in the number two engine room, Charlie Pontoon and Delta Pontoon. Engine exhaust. Into the switchboard room, which previously was the boiler room, we see the two switchboards. One with the controls mounted on the side closest to the port side. for easy access behind the switchboard. With the high suction valve, high and low suction valve for fire pump. Looking between two switchboards. Level of Charlie pontoon, central passageway on the center line. Here we see the starboard vestibule, central passageway. We see the engine cutoff remote trips. Located in the Charlie head. Charlie pontoon. See the general layout. Shower stall. Division berthing, port side forward, Charlie pontoon, upper level. Here you see the port transfer switchboard disconnect box and port dock tie box installed on this berthing part.